In this video, you will learn how to create this beautiful video masking effect. As you can see here, we have a title slide. On a click, you can see that there is a video playing in the background. A couple of examples of this effect in action is this one, where you can see that there is a spotlight on a specific animal, and you can even have a spotlight on a specific object like, say, a flower, etc. This technique is especially useful when you want to create technical presentations. For example, if you want to show how a machine works, you can have the machine working in the video and you can have this kind of a spotlight shown right on your title slide. The same way, if you want to show the video of a virus in action, you can do so. You can arrest the audience's attention right up front with this beautiful video masking effect. Let us learn how to create this awesome looking effect from scratch, and it is surprisingly easy to create. I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Here I am on a new slide. Let us start by creating the mask. The first thing I'm going to do is to draw a rectangle that covers this entire slide. So let me go to home, go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle that covers this slide entirely end to end. And then let us go to Shape Outline and No Outline as usual. Then on this rectangle, let us punch a circular hole that will allow us to showcase the video that is playing in the background. For that, let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again. Let us pick up the oval tool, hold the shift button down and draw a large circle like so. Can you see here? This is the place where the video would be playing. Next, to make this visually more appealing, I want to draw a circular frame around it, which will also be transparent. So let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again. From basic shapes, let me pick up this one called as Circle Hollow. Let us click on this and then draw a circle like so. There is another way you can do this. Let me delete this. Let us make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D. And then let us place this right on top of the earlier one. Then hold the Ctrl and Shift button and then expand this by clicking and dragging from the corner. Can you see that allows us to expand the circle from the center? Then we can always change the shape by going to Edit Shape in the Shape Format option and then go to Change Shape. From Basic Shape, you can choose this one called a Circle Hollow. Both of them have the same effect. Once we have the shape in place, we can always click and move this yellow handle to adjust the width of the ring. Now that looks really nice. Now since we have drawn this using this as the central point, we don't really have to worry too much about aligning it in place. Then let us add some other elements around it to give this even more beautiful look and feel. So I'm going to pick up the oval tool once again and draw a circle like so. And then I'm going to make a copy of this by selecting this and by pressing Ctrl D. And I'm going to place this over here. And just to create a bit of variation, I'm going to reduce the space here, hold the Ctrl button down, and let us move this to another place and then make a smaller circle like so. And then maybe another smaller one somewhere over here. It is just about your own style and taste. Let us make a copy of this over here and then let us readjust the positioning like so. So we are just randomly placing these circles just to give a beautiful design effect. Then let us punch the holes. So I'm going to click and drag across all these shapes that I just created, and I'm going to use Shape Format, Merge Shapes, and use this Shape Union option. Now all these new shapes are now made into one singular shape like this. Now we are going to subtract this shape from the rectangle behind. So first click on the rectangle behind, hold the shift button down and then click on the shape union and then go to merge shapes and then say shape subtract. Now we have created this beautiful mask. Now the beauty of this mask is shown when you insert a video behind. Now to make this look even more dramatic, I'm going to give this black color. Go to shape fill and say black color. And then let us insert the video. Go to insert, go to pictures and go to stock images. Here we have the option to pick up the videos that are available natively as part of PowerPoint. Now, what in case you don't really have a video option available in your PowerPoint version? You can always go to pixabay.com. Here you can search for videos, place your cursor on any of the videos to see a quick preview. You can download them and use them without having to worry about copyright issues. Since I have a Microsoft 365 subscription, I'm going to use the videos option that come with PowerPoint. So let me go to videos and search for a video that will serve my purpose. Now, this video is pretty beautiful because in this area where we had punched the hole, we have action happening. And that is something that I would really like you to keep in mind. Choose those videos where there is some action happening in the area you want to focus on. Let us select this and say insert. And we will have the video inserted onto the slide. You don't really have to do any change whatsoever because all the settings you would need are already taken care of in this default video insertion option. When you click on the video, you will get two of these contextual tabs, one for video format and the other one is for playback. When I click on playback, you can see how this video would play. This video will start automatically and it will loop until stopped, so I don't have to do anything and the video will play just fine. So I'm going to right click on this and send it back. Now you can see we have a nice looking mask for the video. When I go to slideshow, this is how the video would play, drawing the viewer's attention on the subject you want to showcase. Now that we have this beautiful video mask, all we need to do is to draw a couple of lines, write your text that showcases the title of your presentation, and your job is done. For that, let me go to the previous slide where I had already done some work. I'm going to select this element here, which is made of two text boxes, one for the title and the other one for name of the presenter. And I'm going to press Ctrl C, go to the next page, Ctrl V. Now we have got our title written. And then I'm going to draw a couple of lines above and below this title to complete the design. So let me go to the previous slide and let us select all these elements. Let us hold the shift button and click on this to deselect it. Press Ctrl C and then come down here and press Ctrl V. Now the design is complete. Once you learn how to use video masks to enhance the look and feel of your title slides, you can always use the same idea to make your other title slides come to life as well. Now I'm going to show you some creative templates that we have got from Comprehensive All-in-One PowerPoint Bundle version 2.0, where we have nicely animated title slides, where instead of the large picture that is showcased, like in this case you can see, we have a large picture that is stuck here. You can always insert a video and it'll work beautifully. Let me show you another example from Comprehensive All-in-One PowerPoint Bundle. This again has a large picture behind. You can replace this with a video of your choice. Another example is this one, where we have a nice looking design which is in geometric shape that will go pretty well with any of your engineering related presentations. Another example is this one, where you can replace this generic photo with a specific video of your choice. By the way, Comprehensive All-in-One PowerPoint Bundle version 2.0 is our flagship product, which is quite popular among teachers, trainers, consultants, any kind of business professionals. And this bundle has more than 4,200 premium PowerPoint templates with professional custom animation. You can just pick slides from this bundle, paste them onto your slide deck, and customize them in a matter of minutes, and you can make an impactful professional presentations without spending much time. I will leave a link to this useful product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link and get more details about this product by watching this video. And if you like it, you can make a one-time purchase and use these templates for a lifetime. By the way, did you like this beautiful video masking effect? If you did, then you will really love this other tutorial that we have put together for you that shows you how to use creative custom animation to take your PowerPoint slides to the next level. All you need to do is to click on the link and watch the video right now. So go ahead, click on the link, see that video, and I'll see you in the next one.